Hi everyone, welcome to another video. Today I have a very easy watercolor background that I want to share with you. I made it with Catherine Pooler inks, but first, before I share that, I want to remind you to follow me across social media if you haven't already. Those links are going to be down in the description box below. Also, while you're down there, you can subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And if you enjoyed this video, the like button is always appreciated. So I'm going to be using these two stamps today from Cracker Box and Susie Stamps. All the supplies, ink colors, that kind of thing, it's all going to be listed down in the description box. So if you have any questions about that, you can head down there and find the answers. I'm starting off with this white cardstock die cut. I used a die set to die cut this, and I also die cut a yellow mat with a scalloped rectangle that's slightly larger than this one. It's all one die set. Again, that's going to be listed down below. But I'm starting stamping on that white cardstock die cut with my little crayon box and Hello Crafty Friend sentiment. I am using my creative corners to bump up that piece of cardstock away from the edge in my mini Misty. I've also taken the foam pad out so I can stamp with my rubber mounted stamps. I'm using the Midnight Ink from Catherine Pooler. This works really well with all different coloring mediums. And I'm going to be using my alcohol markers to color this in today, so that's why I'm using this. It also stamps beautifully, so you can use it just for regular stamping. I'm going to stamp this down, make sure I give it some really good pressure and get a nice impression, and then it's on to coloring. So like I said, I am using my alcohol markers to color this in. And Catherine Pooler inks, I have found, play really well with my alcohol markers. I do give it a few minutes to dry so it doesn't smear, especially when I'm using lighter colors like these yellows here. So I am starting off by coloring with my yellow markers. I'm using my Dick Blick Studio brush markers. I'm also going to mix in a few of the Artist Loft markers that I picked up recently just to fill in some color holes that I had in my marker collection. Now I'm going to speed this up and also zoom you in so you can see the coloring of this. The only part that I really did put any effort into coloring was the crayon box. It's the largest focal point on this card, so that's where I'm going to put my effort into. I started off with a lighter shade of yellow, came in with a little bit darker for my shadows, and then I actually came in with an orange very, very, very sparingly, just in the darkest spots. Then I came back in with my lightest color and blended everything out. Now, I started off coloring in these crayons with two different colors. I actually used a darker one on the little paper that would be around the crayon, and then a lighter one on the crayon itself. This really did not show up at all, so I just thought, you know what, why go to all that work? I just stuck with one color for the rest of them. So I used a red, a yellow, an orange, a green, a blue, a purple, and then I'm going to come in with a gray as well to finish off that box of crayons. Super, super simple and easy to do. Now I've got this ready to go onto my mat, and I've also got my mat ready to be placed onto my background. Now I put my mat and my little colored image onto my background, and it would look great on white, but I wanted to dress it up a little bit. So I have a piece of white cardstock, plain heavyweight white cardstock. This measures an A2 size, so 4.25 by 5.5. I'm also using Sauna ink from Catherine Pooler. I've just smushed some of that down onto my craft mat, and I'm using this wide paintbrush. This is from Arteza. You can use any wide paintbrush, watercolor brush you have on hand. I spritzed my ink, and I'm just going to use that water brush to pick up some of that ink and just make stripes across it. Now you could do this on watercolor paper, but you might have to do more layers because I find that the watercolor sits on top of the paper a little bit. So I like to use regular cardstock. It's going to soak in very quickly. It's going to give me that vibrancy I want. And I'm not using a whole lot of water here. And I'm not continually going over the same stripe over and over with the water. So I'm not causing any pilling on my paper. I'm also using a very heavyweight cardstock here. This is 110 pounds, so it can stand up to a little bit of water and a little bit of dragging that brush across. You don't want to be too heavy-handed, but you need to make sure that you're using a heavyweight white cardstock. This won't work with anything thin. But this way, it soaks into the paper, it gives me that vibrancy that I want, and it dries super quick. I'm gonna go back in just a few little stripes here and there to add in some darker layers, and then I'll set this aside to dry. It's on regular cardstock, so it doesn't take long, but look at that vibrancy that you get and just the amount of color, and it took maybe a minute and a half, 2 minutes to make that background, and then a few minutes to dry. Now, while that's sitting off to the side drying, I'm going to go ahead and start adding up my layers here. So I'm taking my crayon panel that I've colored in, and I'm matting it with that yellow scalloped rectangle that I cut for the mat. I use just plain regular double-sided adhesive. Now I'm going to go ahead and attach that watercolor piece that I did onto a card base. Now I did this separate from the card base so it could have time to dry and it wouldn't bleed through. It didn't end up bleeding through, but if you did this on your regular card base, you'd have a little bit of warping. So by doing it on a panel, you can put a lot of adhesive on the back. I'm using a very strong double-sided adhesive, and then I'll place it down onto the card base. Again, this is a heavyweight card base, so the strength of that plus the adhesive is going to flatten that out. You won't even be able to tell there was any warping at all. But make sure you use a lot of adhesive and make sure you use a strong one. Then on the back of that yellow panel that I had with my crayons, I added some dimensional adhesive and I'll place that right down in the center on the front of my card. Now I love the way this looks, but I wanted to add a little something extra. So I grabbed my Winkostella clear brush pen. I do have a video about refilling this. I'll leave that linked in the top right hand corner if I remember. Sometimes I don't. A lot of times I don't remember. But I'm just going to go ahead and place a nice layer of that over all of the marker or all of the crayons. Now, because I use the Catherine Pooler ink, this also plays really well with watercolors, so I can get away with that. If I was using Memento or something like that, you need to be a little bit careful and stay away from those black lines. Now I'm going to add a little bit something more right on top of those. I'm going to use clear glossy accents and just put that on top of each one of the crayons. I started with just the tips and the little base on the ones on the bottom, but I ended up covering the entire crayons. I just like the look of it. It makes them so super shiny and just pop away from the background. There's a closer look at that. I just love the gloss you get from the glossy accents whenever you turn it towards the light. Now for the inside of the card, I'm keeping it super simple. I use that same Sauna ink. I watered it down a little bit more so it was a little bit lighter. And I just did a quick little wash over the background, kind of a wonky rectangle shape, made sure I had some nice brush strokes on the side, and that's going to be where I can write my message. I'll give that a good dry with my heat gun. You might want to place this in like a heavy book or something overnight once you get done with it, just to get out any warping that happened. Mine didn't, wasn't too bad, so I just put an acrylic block on top of it overnight and it was fine. To pull the inside of the card right, or pull the outside of the card to the inside of the card, I'm going to go ahead and use that crayon stamp that I used on the front, ink it up with the same Midnight ink from Catherine Pooler, and stamp that down in the bottom left-hand corner just to tie everything in together. And there you have it. Super, super simple and easy. I love the way this card turned out. I love the inside. I think it would be gorgeous as the outside of the card as well. I love it when that happens. And there's a closer look at the outside one final time. That is going to do it for me today. There are links on the left side of your screen that you can click on. You can also subscribe to my channel over there. All the information is going to be down in the description box. Thanks for watching and happy crafting.